Hey everybody! Welcome to a video where I test things so you don't have to, and today we are testing out kitchen stuff that my girlfriend picked out. Now, I am not the master of this kitchen, as we've all grown to learn. Not very good at it. I'm trying! I'm getting better! I'm working on it! I refuse to stop growing as a person! At one point in my life, I was here. Now I'm here. But anyway, I had her pick things out where she was like, this would truly make my experience in the kitchen better. And I said, bet. You got it. I bought it. Now it's time to test it. What do we have? We have a cheese knife thing. Apparently this was crucial to the workings of this kitchen. Next we have an onion cut. This holds your onion while you slice it. Sure. We have a cheese grater. I feel like I have tested every cheese grater known to man. I might have already tested this one and got rid of it, but I don't know. But she wants this one, and this one catches your shavings and keeps it all together. Fantastic. We have an electric can opener because one time she sliced her handle opening a can. No bueno. She's scared of it now. So when I'm not home, how is my woman supposed to open her cans? If I'm not home, I don't want her to live in fear. Not on my watch. Electric can opener. Then we have a jalapeno de-seeder. This seeds your jalapenos, gets rid of them, throws them out. And lastly, I was surprised to see this, but apparently this will up our kitchen to the next level. And that is a deluxe sandwich maker. Ready? Let's begin. We're gonna need an apron for this, even though I don't wanna cover up my new merch. Get it here. Now, until ever, unladylike with new coloring. There you go. Link down below if you wanna support. Now, this cheese knife. So I asked my girlfriend before I filmed this, I said, what cheese am I supposed to slice with this? What kind of cheese? She handed me this block of cheese. This is the cheese in which I'm supposed to slice with this knife. As you wish, my dear, as you wish. Oh my God, I have to wash my hands. Here we go. Oh, that smells rancid. This is a creamy Toscano cheese soaked in syrup, Ready? Oh, look how that just came right off. That was easily, wait, I need to see what it's like with a knife. Oh, we have a normal knife. You want a slice of cheese? Coming right up. Oh, that's not very thin, and that was difficult to do. Oh, don't worry. I'll get you a thin slice of Tuscanagano. Served up real nice. Okay, well, it definitely slices it thinner than if you were to do a knife. Okay, actually, it was pretty easy with the knife. Sometimes I think the world just makes things that don't need to be invented. Cheese knives are one of them, because this knife, it works just as well. Am I missing something? Is it quicker? It is pretty quick. Okay, I'm gonna say it's slightly quicker. You know exactly what size you're getting each time. It works, I guess, if you're really in the cheese business. But I kinda like my knife a little better. I guess your knife is scarier. It does what it says it's gonna do. And that's more than we can ask for in this economy. I'm gonna say it works. It probably would look nicer on a cheese tray more than a knife. You get the same size cut every time. It's less thinking and about a millisecond faster. So I would say this does in fact work. It is a cheese knife, to which is that a knife used upon cheese. 7 out of 10. Not wowed, but it does its job. Next product, an onion cutter. Cutting up onions isn't fun. People cry about it. But with this, it's supposed to be easier. Now I'm no amateur. I know I'm gonna need my goggles. Let's see how easy this is. I mean, does this look like the picture or what? Come on! I have nailed that! Ready? Moment of truth. That was so easy. Now, if you want to, you can even hold it here. Are you kidding me? I'm not gonna lie to you, I was fully prepared to roast this. To be like, oh, it saves you like 2 seconds, blah, blah, blah. No, this is a plot twist. Yeah, slicing it this way, okay, whatever, it's cool, you get the same size ones every time, yada, yada. But to have it held steady while you chop all of these, that is such a time saver. This is brilliant. I actually very much enjoy this. Look how much, this is satisfying. You gotta get a close up. Look at this.
Oh, yes!
And they're all the same size!
You gotta get closer.
Just look at it. Are you kidding me?
10 out of 10 would recommend.
Shut up.
All right, next up in our glorious kitchen is the jalapeno seed remover.
I love taking this blue tape off. Watch this. Oh, no, this is not satisfying at all. This is the opposite of satisfying. This is horribly unsatisfying. It keeps just peeling off. Okay, does it need to come from this angle? Dear God, that was the opposite of what I wanted to happen in my life just now. Why won't this come off? Why are you the worst thing that's ever happened to me? And I dated a man. Okay, whoever put this stuff on, Miso, I have the same feelings as you do right now. Frustration. I just want happiness, and everything is stopping me from it. There is the blue inside those still. How am I supposed to get to that?
My life is such a struggle.
Whoever invented this, I'm suing. I have to figure out how to get that out.
If you want to have the most frustrating, worst time of your entire life, buy this!
Reset and begin.
Hello and welcome. It came with no instruction, so maybe I'll look. Okay, fine, I'll look up the instructions. Figured it out!
Stop screaming as well. It's a little aggressive.
You use this part to cut the jalapeno. Not a very good cut. There we go.
Then you stick this inside it and twist as you go in.
Okay, I'm gonna need a paper towel for this.
Twist it and then pull. And then pull out. Dun, 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 dun. And boom! It's done. I guess if you need to have your pepper looking like this, like you need to hollow it out, that works. It says you can also use it for cucumbers.
Oh.
That's fun. Okay, I got different peppers.
Because I wanted to try different peppers.
We have a yellow chili pepper. Cut off the top. Take that out. Boom. Nope, it didn't get it all. Pop, 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 pop. No, there's still some in there. There we go. Gotta really dig it out. Yeah, she works. Okay, we have one more.
We got a habanero pepper.
Oh, dear God. This one, she's too fragile. Oh, make sure I wash my hands after this. She's too fragile, but guess what? She worked well with the jalapeno and the yellow chili pepper.
Let me wash my hands.
I'm gonna be smart. It says it can work with a cucumber. So we're gonna cut this cucumber in half. We're gonna see if it can create a hole in this bad boy. Ready? Oh my God, it's so juicy. Cheese in that, I'll just eat it. All right, she works. 9 out of 10. Oh, some juice got in my cut. Oh, it's painful. Woo! Woo! I'm in pain. I knew that I would. So much pain. Bow, bow. I got some pain. Bow, 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 bow. Okay, I'm done. Moving on.
All right, next up in Rachel's kitchen is the cheese grater. I'm gonna grate some carrots with it because I like to sprinkle shredded carrots. Oh my! I dropped this medieval shaving contraption. As I was saying, my dogs like to have a little shredded carrot on their dinner at night. So I bought whole carrots to shred. This is a lot in one contraption, dear God.
Yes, the bottom does open up. And we have a thin shredder, a whatever that one is, shredder, and a garlic grinder.
And then it came with this thing.
It's a shaver, like a potato shaver.
So I'm gonna see how that works on my carrots. So first off, let's see how this baby goes.
Now, I'm no head chef by any means. Y'all, I can't tell when chicken's done. Salmon scares me. I don't understand seasonings. But what I am good at is being a sous chef. I'm a darn good sous chef, which means I'm always the peeler. So I know a good peeler when I see one.
Can you go back?
It can go both ways. Oh, that's good. Oh, goodness. Okay. Now, what's this doohickey on the back? It's got a different vibe to it.
What is that? Oh, we've created long, thin chunks of something. Okay, I don't know what you would need that for, but it exists. I prefer this over anything else, but that's fine.
This part works, Very well. This part works. I don't know what you'd use it for. But now, does this work? Let us find out. Now, with a carrot, you need to do it like this. Here we go. Ready? A little bit came out. Oh, yeah. A little bit is falling. We have to have a clear workstation for this. A little bit has fallen. A little bit is falling. Now, what if we do a huge cucumber? There we go. There we go. It's happening. It's happening. There's a mess. There's a mess. We're supposed to catch it in here. And yet I have a trail of essence. There's evidence that I shredded here. There shouldn't be. I've been bamboozled. That's a good carrot. I think I'm in a bad mood because I'm hungry. Huh, I don't know. Yeah. I will say it's a little bit easier than a normal grater, for sure. It's holding it, everything. It was actually very easy to hold while grating. It made a little bit of a mess, but all graters do. I'm gonna give it an 8 out of 10. I liked this doohickey. I was mad that there was an essence. I'm like, what are you gonna do? Does this look appetizing? Are you a rabbit? I have to sneeze and it's not gonna happen. And I'm gonna be mad about it. Yep, I'm mad. Next product. It's time to make my woman feel safe in the kitchen again. And I will never let her open another can by hand ever again. Okay, we have a can of tuna.
Oh.
Oh! And she won't cut herself. I mean, she still could, but not very unlikely just to cut yourself on this now.
That was so easy.
What? I wanna see how well it works on a big can. Lift, make sure the knife is on the inside of that. Oh, I spilled my juice. Ooh, that smells really good. God, I love some mango, man. Oh, I just put a little cottage cheese and a little salt. Oh, yeah. I think this is a phenomenal can opener. I find it very hard to hurt yourself on it. I really liked it. Now, it also says on the back is a knife sharpener. It says you just stick it in the back here and go back and forth. I will not be able to tell you if this is sharper now or not, but it sounded like it was doing something. So there's that. How do you know if it's doing anything? How am I supposed to test this? I'm supposed to do it for a long time? What's the rules here? Looks like a knife to me. Oh well. Time for the thing I'm most excited about. Give me a warm sandwich. Yes! Oh ho ho. It's about to get dirty up in here. Filthy! Get really dirty and filthy, let's go. My favorite thing is when food is dirty. That's what I call when it's like greasy, buttery, sugary, anything that's like gonna clog your arteries, give you a heart attack, shorten your lifespan. Ooh, that's dirty. And it's delicious. Carrot, not dirty. But I don't clean eat. Don't talk about clean eating. That's not even a freaking thing. That's something diet culture made up.
Clean eating?
Were you scrubbing your food with Clorox first? No, but ugh. There's dirty food for sure. And we're about to make some.
Let me read the instructions.
Okay, I touched the side. Don't touch it, it's hot. I minus a point for that. I didn't think it was gonna get that hot that fast. So what it says to do, while this is heating up, it takes 5 to 8 minutes, it says, we're going to prepare our sandwich. It says prepare your fillings. We're gonna try and use sourdough bread for one. We're gonna make two, because I wanna make sure this thing works right. And we're gonna do Wonder Bread. For the second sandwich. I think the first one is just gonna be cheese and turkey. And then the second one we'll get more creative with it. We're gonna do two different types of cheeses. Now there's a vegan cheese and vegan turkey. So things may vary. Now the second sandwich, I think we're gonna get a little fancy. I think we're gonna saute up some artichoke hearts, onions, and mushroom. And put that with some cheese and a little pesto. I know, we're getting crazy. Oh, my girlfriend's calling me.
More important,
baby. All right, I'm sauteing up some mushroom, onion, artichoke,
artichoke heart. We're just gonna get that good sauteed. And we're just waiting. I'm thinking the fancier sandwich on the sourdough, the basic sandwich on the Wonder Bread. You feel me? You feel me. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Okay, okay, okay. It said to add some butter. We're gonna do one sandwich at a time here. You need to see this, don't you? You should see this. You deserve to see this. We got this one is basic. Boom. This, and this. And we are going to close this. Boom. Toast for 3 to 6 minutes or until golden brown. 3 minutes on the clock. And test that out. My timer has gone off. Let's see. Oh yeah, that looks good. That, a little uneven, but that's fine. All right, now we're gonna do it again, but with the sourdough. Okay, this is gonna be a little troublesome because it doesn't quite fit. Figure it out. Sauteed this beforehand. Hold on, I'm gonna put some pesto sun-dried tomatoes on this. Yeah, there. Put butter on this side. Oh, this is dirty.
Dirty, dirty, dirty.
Oh, I love it. Okay, do that. And smush. All right, you and I are gonna take a bite of this bad boy. Oh, oh, yeah.
Oh my god, so good.
Mmm. Oh, heck yes! I wish I could cuss on this channel. Oh my gosh. Hold on. I need to get some ketchup up in this business.
It's so hot.
I don't care. I will burn my mouth for this any day. Yes. I'm so happy. I'm so happy. It's like the best grilled cheese you'll ever have. Every house should have a panini press. It's a deluxe sandwich maker. It's not even a panini press. It's just a deluxe sandwich maker.
Let me tell you, this sandwich is deluxe.
Oh, it's such a good grilled cheese.
Okay.
I don't think you're ready for this jelly.
I don't think you're ready for this. My body too food delicious for you, babe.
Dripping, dripping. Yes. Oh, I'm so happy. Give me my things. Give me all my things. I don't think you're ready for this jelly. I don't think you're ready for this. My body too food delicious for you, babe.
Yes.
I've never been so in love with a sandwich.
Oh my God.
I could marry this sandwich. Beautiful.
That is so good. I love this so much.
I'm obsessed with that sandwich. All right, but the flaws with this thing are cleaning, you have to just wipe it down. These don't come out, you can't rinse them like a waffle maker. You have to wipe them down with a paper towel. Cleaning factor is a little difficult. And then you can't, I mean, I guess you could use huge things of sourdough bread, but like you're kind of limited on the space. I don't think you'd be able to do two sandwiches at once because even my Wonder Bread was going over. So it's a little small. I guess if you used a whole slice on like the sourdough, like a huge sourdough ones, you could do it that way. But size-wise, you're slightly limited and cleaning, it's not the best. I'm gonna give it a 9 out of 10. I really enjoyed it. Absolutely delicious. Warm sandwiches. Way easier than making a grilled cheese on the stove. I say yes. But that's it, guys. That's all the products. I very much enjoyed them. The only thing I was like, well, about was the cheese knife. All right, please subscribe to see videos every Tuesday on this channel. Like this video if you liked it. If there are ever any products you'd like me to test, please let me know down below, or you can DM them to me on Instagram. Make sure you're checking out my podcast channel, my vlog channel, my Snapchat, my TikTok, and my Instagram. You guys are wonderful, beautiful people. I have a lot of food here I need to consume, and I'm gonna be happy doing it. So, you're wonderful and beautiful. Bye!